Hello, I'm Vidas Pinkevičius, and today I'm going to talk about some of the most easiest ways to harmonize a hymn in four parts. So, what's the first thing you have to do when you are going to harmonize a hymn in four parts? Well, basically it's very simple. You have to write down the melody, the tune, on the sheet of paper using the staff notation, and put a key signature, meter signature, and just notate the melody with the stems up. That will be your soprano line, okay? Once you do that, you have to figure out the cadences, okay? The places to breathe and harmonize the cadences first. The cadences can be finished on the dominant or the tonic, open or closed cadences, half or perfect cadences. So just be aware what kind of cadences there are in each line, in each ending of each line of this hymn. Okay, and then of course you have to know the basic notes of the chords for each note of that soprano tune, of soprano melody. So what you can usually do is you can for example take this melody and think in terms of chords: tonic, subdominant, and dominant, and just notate the letter T, S, or D. T for tonic, S for subdominant, and D for dominant, beneath each note of the soprano tune. Okay, so that's how you can do this, and then you will be able to decide what chord fits best for each note of this hymn, right? So, for example, if the tune is in C major, then tonic chord would be C, E, G. And if for example, in the melody you see any note with C, E, or G, you will know that it's a tonic chord. It fits perfectly well. Then there is a subdominant chord based on the fourth scale degree, F, A, and C. So in any instance you see these three pitches, you can decide to use the subdominant chord. And the same is with the dominant. It's only that the pitches for the dominant chord is of course G, B, and D in C major. So anywhere in the melody you see these three pitches, you can use the dominant chord, okay? And just to observe the proper voice leading, so you have to avoid parallel fifths, parallel octaves, and most of the time use constant notes and connect these several chords with a stepwise motion, unless there is a skip a little bit by the third interval of the third. So basically it's a simple process. You have to just follow the rules of voice leading, avoid if parallel fifths and parallel octaves, and aim for the contrary motion in the bass line. That's the main emphasis in the bass line. If the melody goes up, the bass line can go down, and vice versa. So follow these tips when you harmonize a hymn in four parts, and you will see how easy this process can be. By the way, if you want to learn how to master any piece of organ music up to 10 times faster, you can download my free video organ practice guide. And just click on the link below this video in the description box, and you will be able to watch this video and see for yourself and apply these tips in practice, so that you can also master any organ piece, difficult, easy, fast, or slow, by any composer, up to 10 times faster. That's how powerful these practice techniques are. Thanks for watching this video. I'm Vidas Pinkevičius, and I'll see you again very soon.